really tired, running on a few hours sleep, but I'm out here on the Kawarthas, Sturgeon Lake, my stomping ground. Been fishing the last couple days, haven't got much. A couple smallmouth, that's been it. Out here this morning, trying to look for some walleye.
Could have been the Willie Nelson. Could have been.
Got him. Get the net ready, let's go. Come on. Is that a walleye? A walleye here. Let me see. Like, I don't understand why you keep saying low voltage. Oh, just had a fish. Yeah, I got one. Yeah, just leave it. Put it here and just hang the big part over it. Yep. Put the whole mesh in the water. I don't have a clue what this is, but walleye or muskie. Yeah, I'm filming right now. This is some of the best footage I've got. It's gotta be a muskie. This thing's not even moving. It's exactly what it is. That's a big walleye. Oh my God. That's gotta be 30 inches. Jesus.
Cajun, I saw the constellations reveal themselves one star at a time.
Another big walleye. Oh my God. I just cannot say no to these swim baits. That's a big fish. Gorgeous looking fish. Real nice looking fish. Oh my God, look at all the fish he's spitting up. He just spit up three fish. Yeah, they're floating in the water. They're sinking at the back of the boat. First cast. Can't beat that. Working
quitting, thought I
some shallower water looking for walleye. There's one. That is not a walleye. That thing no sooner. Welcome to the post-fishing report. This is my post-fishing bait report. I hope you enjoyed the video. It's my first time using the program to edit, so it's not going to be the best quality for the editing, but it's going to get nothing but better. And I forgot to do the video while I was fishing to show you guys exactly what I was using and how I was fishing it. All right, guys, here we are at the post-fishing report for the baits. Now, these baits specifically that I use are made by the gentleman of Greg Finney, and I'm very fortunate to have him as a sponsor. And I mean, this gentleman's baits are just unbelievable. I've used these all winter and spring for walleye in the river, and I use these for everything, musky, pike, bass, walleye, you name it, I catch them on it. The quality of these baits is just unbelievable. It's got very nice barbs in the hook to hold those baits on. The jig heads, he pours all different colors, a lot of different sizes. You want it, he'll make it. You can't beat the price on these things, I am telling you. I shot some footage with these, but I could not use the footage for some reasons. But these are nice little minnows. I usually drop shot these, but I mean, these baits all together, guys, are just unbelievable. He just got the mold for these in a couple of weeks ago, and I really bugged him for a smaller profile swim bait, and I got him. You know, and it's very simple. All I do is just put it on, slide it up, and that's it. You're good to go, and it's got a nice bend in it. It really looks like a wounded fish. Now, you see in the video, I was using a lot of white. Just for me, personally, up on the Kawarthas, white has always been a real good color. And this was it right here. Just a plain Jane white swim bait. The jig head he pours himself to. This has got some pink, orange, chartreuse, and white. And the chartreuse is actually glow, along with this bait itself. Hey, everyone, I just want to say thank you for checking out my video. I really appreciate the support. I did want to mention real quick, too, smallmouth bass rives fishing in the Kawarthas is closed. But it's very difficult to go to a lake where the fish are really concentrated and focused in a very small water column to go in there targeting walleye and getting smallmouth bass or largemouth. It's gonna happen. I just wanted to let you guys know that all those smallmouth were released without harm. They swam back. It is completely fine. A lot of people are gonna look down on stuff like that. Oh, you put a video up of you catching smallmouth. Yeah, you know what? I've heard it all. It's fine. What do you want me to do? I just wanted to really stress that all those fish were released without harm. I did not intentionally target those fish. And real quick, I just wanted to say, again, thank you for all the support. Thank you for watching my video. I do got some merchandise here, The Slick Fisherman. You can find me on Facebook. I got a Facebook page, The Slick Fisherman. I have an Instagram account, The Slick Fisherman. This is the first video on my YouTube. We're gonna get this thing pumping out there. If you want some merchandise, you know where to find me. Get a hold of me. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Any support helps. I really appreciate it. Thank you, guys. Fish on. Tight lines.